nice tan. She never lost the tan. It's so adorable. And I remember it at a little age, I think you were 4. And we just, everyone had a special love for you. And you're so gentle, and your spirit was so loving. As I was thinking about this week, we've seen you grow into such a beautiful woman. You look beautiful today, you look very handsome. We've seen God mature you, and the fear of the Lord be developed in your life, compassion for other people. You never lost that gentleness. Everyone loves being around you. You can tell by the friends that you keep how your friends are just so beautiful. And Amanda, I want to tell you that it's an honor to do your wedding. So, myself, we love you. We love seeing you grow up as a young teenager, coming over our house, prayer, movies, sleepovers, seeing God develop you as a virtuous woman, very virtuous woman. We're here to celebrate what God is doing in your life. You offer very unique gifts. You bring to the table a gentleness, a calmness, a determination. I've seen that in the last few years. You press through, a spirit of perseverance, even when things weren't going right, even as a child, you push through. Parents, good job. Good job, both of your parents. Peter, I haven't known you for 20 years, but I've known you for the last 2, and I'm New Year's Day, when you proposed to Amanda, all the family was seeing this man that was determined, rock, confident, very creative, very persuasive, loves life. You're bringing to this marriage the gift of dream, the gift of leadership, the gift of knowing where you're going to go, and you're a man that really honors God. And Peter was talking to me a few months back. He said, Uncle Mark, you're making this pretty easy. He said, I thought this talk would be a lot harder. I said, Peter, I've already been checking you out the last 2 days. And all the background checks came out pretty clean. But no, I see it. You know what? I've seen you come to every function, family function. And you're a man that loves the Lord. I've seen you even come to church this morning, because he just wanted to have that quiet time with the Lord. And it's just an honor to welcome you to our family and just to see the life you're going to grow together. But you know, it's very important that as you have these gifts, as you understand that you're 2 different people and you're completing one another, how do you maintain this level of love and growth and encouragement? And how do you go from glory to glory? The Bible says a threefold cord is not easily broken. I believe the 3 parts of that cord is love. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 13, love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy, does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, does not provoke, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears, believes, hopes, and endures. Love never fails. You want that strong threefold cord? Love, healthy love. Honor. You must honor one another with your words at all times. Because you know that God has given you a gift. You must honor that gift in the way you speak to Amanda, the way you speak to Peter, in your actions. The Bible says in Corinthians to submit as a wife and as a husband to love your wife as Christ loved the church. And the third part of that threefold cord is forgiveness. Jesus' disciple says, how many times should we forgive? 7, 10, 20, innumerable. If you have a tender heart and continue to forgive and ask God to correct you when you're wrong, your marriage is going to be successful. You're going to have that threefold cord. Jesus demonstrated that when he was on the cross. And I know that you have confessed Christ as your Savior. You have the fruit of the Spirit. In your life, people can see it, you can see your love. I said, forgive them, and they do not know what they do. Amanda, you might say that a lot before you go to bed. Forgive him, Father. You might be saying that. Peter, I told you I wasn't going to pick that yet. But I respect you guys and love you guys, and I wish the best for you. Peter, in order to have this type of marriage, to have that 3-4 point in your marriage, will you promise to all these promises to your family, to love, honor, forgive, and end it at all times? Will you? Peter, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live in the holy state of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep you only to her as long as you both shall live? Amanda, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in a holy state of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, keep him in sickness and health, forsaking all others, keep you only to him as long as you both shall live? Yeah, I want you to face each other, but I want you to exchange your vows. Peter at this time is going to express his written vows to you. Thank you.
that is math I studied. When I was 16 years old, I wrote down the qualities that I wanted. Some of them being a man after God's own heart, has vision for his life, prays without ceasing, hard working, funny, can make me laugh like my brother can, romantic, original, desires purity and to honor God, and someone to look at me with nothing but love in his eyes. God truly heard my prayer as a young girl. His blessing went with you, a man that has his qualities and even better qualities. I love you with all of my heart, and I promise to be faithful to you, always with an ear ready to listen. I promise to support you in all the crazy yet brilliant ideas that you get. I promise to keep the house clean, to respect you, to honor you, and to love you unconditionally. I'm so excited to spend the rest of my life with you. You're so
these rings are an outward, visible sign of an inward spiritual bond which unites the man and woman in an endless love. Could you take the man's ring, place it on her finger, and repeat this? I give this ring as a sign of the covenant between us this day, as a promise of our mutual love. In the name of the Father,
Father,
Son, Holy Spirit. I give this ring as a sign of the covenant between us this day, as a promise of our mutual love. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Wedding party around Peter and Amanda, and best man Joe's.
Let us pray. Jesus, thank you for this beautiful day, God, where we have two awesome people getting married and becoming one. God, I pray for their marriage, God, as they go through life, God. Whatever it goes bad, God, let them love each other who they are. Whatever it goes bad, God, let them love each other who they are, God, regardless of what happens. Whatever controversial situation happens, God, regardless of what happens, God, let them continue to love each other who they are, God. Jesus, I pray that you'd be in this spirit.